Right now, America's cities need big upgrades to keep up with the effects of climate change. Two people in particular are tackling an emergency that's worsening by the day: broken infrastructure, floods, and polluted runoff.
I'm Greg Johnson. I am the CEO of AquiPor. I'm also a co-founder.
The team behind AquiPor, Greg Johnson and Kevin Kunz, is the definition of solution-oriented. As American water systems age and once predictable weather patterns change, the founders of AquiPor saw potential. What if stormwater wasn't a liability to our cities, but rather an asset? Before we get too far, tell us, what exactly is AquiPor?
AquiPor is really an engineering and construction management company for specialty stormwater projects. And our bread and butter really is a material technology. It's a permeable surface technology that's like concrete, but it's extremely permeable and it has nanoscale porosity throughout the material. And what this does is it actually filters out dirt, debris, pollen, dust, all the sedimentary pollution commonly found in stormwater that is known to get into our storm drains and then eventually ends up discharged into, you know, our lakes, rivers, and streams. And so we have this material technology and corresponding engineered designs that go around the material to help cities and private property owners manage large volumes of stormwater right where it falls.
In 2017, the United States got back their infrastructure report card from the American Society of Civil Engineers. It didn't look great. D+. Dams, drinking water, inland waterways, and levees all got a D. Filtering stormwater through our roads would not only alleviate stress from our current systems, but would also reclaim a bit of clean water before it's gone. With all these staggering numbers, what finally drove you to create AquiPor?
We saw a huge need years ago. My co-founder Kevin and I, we saw this kind of need, and I came a little bit from the real estate world, where property developers were always complaining, it seemed like, about having to put stormwater facilities on a new development. And they always took up a huge footprint and they were expensive. And at least this is kind of the developer's perspective back then. And we're in Washington State, and Washington State's pretty progressive. We have some strict stormwater rules. And I just constantly was hearing this from developers, and we noticed that, you know, being able to manage stormwater right where it falls, like if you could figure that out, you were going to solve a huge pain point. And so we started researching it, and we saw that there were permeable pavements in the world. Like, that was a technology that had been developed. I don't want to denigrate the technology because they're still out there, but there were some real material limitations with those, and it really had to do with the fact that they clogged up very quickly. And so my co-founder and I thought, you know, there's got to be a better way to do this. Could we come up with a material technology that actually filtered out this dirt and debris and didn't clog up over time? And so it's been a long, tedious journey of R&D to get to this point, but that's really how it all started, is just finding a better way to provide a functional pavement surface that could be driven on, walked on, parked on, but also solve the stormwater problem right there.
In what ways are you hoping AquiPor will impact this industry?
What we'd like to do is, right off the bat, as soon as we're commercialized and we're to market, we want to get into communities and start making them more resilient against the impacts of, let's call it what it is, a climate crisis right now. So you see communities being inundated with, you know, urban flooding. These are communities now that are being inundated with climate change. Like, this is happening. On the West Coast where we're at, we're dealing more with like a mega drought, and it makes it all the more important that when it does rain, we can get water back into the ground naturally, recharge groundwater, start replenishing aquifers. And so that's the impact we want to make, is let's make our communities more resilient with smart infrastructure. But it goes a level deeper than that too with our technology. And we actually think that our material or mix design could be a negative emissions technology. And once that's proven out, we hope that this is something that gets adopted by precast concrete manufacturers throughout the world, because we actually think we can have a direct impact on lowering the total amount of CO2 that's blown off into the atmosphere from industry. So making our communities just more resilient in the face of these extreme weather events. And we don't want to act like we're the end all kind of silver bullet solution, but we certainly think we can play a part. Like, we can be a piece of that. We see what impact this could make.
Even a small amount of rainfall in urban communities can cause serious damage, thanks to the high ratio of non-porous paved land. Already, 1 in 10 people in the U.S. live in high-risk flood zones. But what Greg and Kevin are saying is that if we could figure out ways to make these hard surfaces permeable, we'll have taken a huge step in the right direction. Speaking of which, what has been the biggest learning lesson from this journey?
Patience. There's so many nuances and so many different variables that you have to be patient and you have to learn from every iteration. The other thing is iterate very quickly, make very small bets that could have outsized returns, have an end result in mind. If you don't hit it, then just scrap it and go on to the next. But make those small bets, and if they turn out, then you're gonna have, you know, an outsized return. We've done that. Now we're to the point where the outsized return is we have a manufacturing process.
What advice can you offer other aspiring entrepreneurs?
If you can, remind yourself, enjoy every moment, good and or bad, because what you perceive as bad at the time could end up being one of the best things that has happened to you and to the startup. And so enjoy every moment, be patient, and be very careful about who you take advice from. I think especially the better your idea is, there's going to be a lot of people that have a lot of advice. Listen to it, but take the advice of people that have been where you're trying to go or have a vested interest in what you're doing. Otherwise, the other advice can be noise.